I can count the few times that I've been speechless, and this is almost one of them. But I can't tell you how proud I am. And first of all, I've got to pat myself on the back, if you don't mind, because I've waited for this opportunity to come along, and I'm proud of myself for when opportunity knocked, being ready to answer. That's what I call a perfect fit. Now that's what I call a perfect fit. And believe me, it's gonna take an act of Congress to get it off my waist. I've got the fever now, and if I got the backing from you, believe me, Ron Simmons will be the people's champion. I couldn't have done it without you. I thank you for staying behind me, and believe me, I promise you I will do everything in my power to represent this belt and to represent you like your champion should. Thank you.
TBS and WCW Saturday Night. My name is Jim Ross, and I'll be your host for the next 2 hours of exciting wrestling action. You're going to see the new World's Heavyweight Champion, Ron Simmons. Also, Sting is here. Plus, Jake the Snake Roberts will be here live with us at center stage. But a man that certainly has his sights set on the World Television Championship, currently held by Stunning Steve Austin, is my good friend, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. And Dragon, you're hot on the heels of the man that they say is the greatest television champion of all time.
Well, that's right, Jim Ross. I'm hot on his heels. His claim to fame is the fact that he is the longest reigning national television champion ever. Well, that's fine and dandy, Mr. Steve Austin, and that tells me that your time is running out, that the odds are stacked against you. I had you on national television. I took you to the outer limits. I'm still suffering from some hurt ribs, but I took you to the limit, and what happened? Paulie Danielson decides to throw in some brass knucks into the course of that match, and I beat you to the punch. That's right, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. And if you want to use them on me, and if I get them first, brother, I will use them on you, and I showed that I use them on you. But my goal is to, for myself and all these outstanding fans here, and that is I'm going to still be hot on your trail. I'm still going after the national television title. And Paulie Dangerously, what's your man going to do when this dragon is 100% healthy with no hurt ribs?
What a matchup it will be for the World Television Championship. Fans, let's go up to our ring announcer, my friend, Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring area at 260 pounds, from Austin, Texas, Dustin Rhodes!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you know, Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham deeply involved in a tag team feud with Greg the Hammer Valentine and Dirty Dick Slater. Let's hear Slater and Valentine's comments made earlier today.
Dustin Rhodes, you may be walking to the ring right now, but just remember, like in your very own words, you said, we didn't finish the job, Slater and Valentine. Well, we are going to finish the job, Dustin. You and Barry Windham, I can't wait.
Well, some very strong and poignant words from Valentine and Slater. And that situation could be settled as early as tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock right here in Atlanta in the Omni. Good fireman carry takeover by Dustin Rhodes. We'll be talking to Dustin a little bit later in the program about that situation. Rhodes working on the arm of Joe Kazana. Kazana, an outstanding competitor. Certainly could put a big notch in his gun and upsetting Dustin Rhodes here. Fans, as we mentioned, we've got a big, big broadcast. Johnny B. Badd is here. You'll also see Big Josh, second on beautiful Bobby Eaton. We'll talk to Nikita Koloff. Good arm drag takeover by Dustin Rhodes. Larry Zbyszko is here. We'll get an update on his injury situation. As many of you that were with us last week, I'm sure will remember that Arn Anderson and beautiful Bobby broke Zbyszko's arm right here on the broadcast last Saturday. Rhodes with the arm bar. Firmly in control here of this contest. So many things right now in WCW. Indeed, the action here and around the country is really red hot. Kazana with the right hand in the midsection, but Dustin fires right back up with the right hand. Sting and Jake the Snake Roberts have a date with destiny. Ron Simmons, the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, in a big rematch coming up with Big Van Vader. We're also going to talk to Paulie Dangerously about the business deal that he has struck with Dr. Death Steve Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy. So we've got a lot for you here in the next couple of hours, and we're very, very pleased that you're with us as Rhodes with the hammerlock firmly in control here, as we mentioned. Dropping that knee right to the bicep. Dustin continuing to keep the pressure on the arm of Joe Kazana. And Kazana scoops him up, but Dustin holds on to the arm. Maintains his control through that body slam there. Some great action coming up in the next few days here in WCW. As we mentioned, the Omni is tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock. It's Kids Day Out. Two kids admitted absolutely free when accompanied by an adult. And then action continues this Wednesday in Little Rock, Arkansas. Thursday in Alexandria, Louisiana. Friday in Shreveport, Louisiana. 1 week from tonight in Monroe, Louisiana. And then 1 week from tomorrow at 3 o'clock. That's 1 week from tomorrow in New Orleans, downtown. And there's the lariat. Dustin Rhodes really caught Kazana with that lariat. Forces him back to the corner. Irish whips him in. Kazana's out, and he's back down from that bulldog. Dustin Rhodes with a bulldog, and the leg is hooked.
The winner of the match, Dustin Rhodes!
Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham are ready for the challenge of Greg the Hammer Valentine and Dirty Dick Slater. As I said, it could be settled as early as tomorrow afternoon right here in Atlanta in the Omni. The big Kids Day Out celebration begins at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Dustin Rhodes, you see, scoring right there with a lariat. And then the youngster from Austin, Texas, puts the finishing touches on Joe Kazana with the bulldog. And when we come back, we'll talk to the natural right after this timeout. Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night here with the natural Dustin Rhodes. Very impressive victory. But from the sound of things, Valentine and Slater are really gunning for you and your partner, Barry Windham.
Well, first of all, I don't think Greg the Hammer Valentine accomplished what he wanted to, and that was trying to hurt my leg. Now, Greg the Hammer Valentine and Dick Slater, sooner or later down this road in professional wrestling, you're going to have to face Rhodes and Windham, and we're going to teach you about pain.
Ron Simmons will be here, Dustin. I know it was an exciting night on August 2nd in Baltimore. Ron winning the heavyweight championship of the world.
My congratulations to Ron Simmons. He accomplished what every professional athlete, especially a professional wrestler, would want to do. That is to win the world heavyweight championship. Now, Ron Simmons, that's also my goal. I want to be the world champion too.
All right, so Ron Simmons, here's a young man that would certainly like the opportunity to wrestle you somewhere down the road. Fans, let's go back up to Rhubarb Jones and our next event on WCW Saturday night.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way into the ring area at 245 pounds from Macon, Georgia, here comes Johnny B. Opponent already in the ring from Orange Park, Florida, at 230 pounds, this is Mike Thor.
Mike Thor to challenge Johnny B. Badd, and indeed the goal of every athlete is to be the best they can be. And Dustin Rhodes certainly has his sights set on someday competing for the heavyweight championship of the world, as Johnny B. Badd a young man who has his sights set on a championship as well. The championship currently held by Brad Armstrong. And the WCW Light Heavyweight Champion, as we reported last week, on the injury list right now with an injured knee. We don't know exactly when Brad will be back in action. We hope early September, and we'll keep you updated on that situation as soon as we receive more information. Johnny B. Badd, as flamboyant as ever here on WCW Saturday night. Still to come here in our first hour, one-on-one competition featuring Big Josh and Beautiful Bobby. We'll talk to Nikita Koloff. We'll also see the Vegas Connection and tag team competition, and we'll talk to Larry Zbyszko and get an update on his situation after he sustained the broken arm last week right here on this broadcast, thanks to the efforts of Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby Eaton. Irish whip to the center of the ropes. Johnny B. Badd showing great agility and quickness here. Badd in the arm drag takeover. Good drop kick. Takes Mike Thor back down. Another arm drag. And Johnny B. Badd at 234, just 2 pounds under the light heavyweight limit, the maximum an athlete can weigh in WCW to compete in this division is 236 pounds. Badd with that arm bar in control here at this point in time in the contest. Mike Atkins is the official. Thor reverses the wrist lock, but not for long. It's Johnny B. Badd with a good fireman carry takeover, takes Thor back down and goes back to work on the arm bar. Some major action, and we're going to talk to Nikita Koloff about the major action tomorrow afternoon. Again, it's a 3 o'clock start in the Omni. Great opportunity for the families to join us tomorrow. Remember, it's Kids Day Out, two kids admitted free with a paid adult admission. And the action will start at 3 o'clock in the Omni tomorrow. Tickets on sale at all Ticketmaster outlets as Mike Thor opens up the right hands. Has a small advantage here now. Catching Johnny B. Badd with the clothesline. So Mike Thor has gained the advantage here offensively against one of the top light heavyweight contenders in WCW. And this time he set a little early, and he paid for it in kind. That left hook has found its mark.
The winner of the match, Johnny B. Badd.
I'm sure Johnny B. Badd will be anxious to hear the update on the status of Brad Armstrong. Armstrong with a knee injury. We'll keep you updated, as I mentioned, on that in the upcoming weeks here. We'll take another look at it right here. Thor said early, Johnny B. Badd made him pay with that left hook. Fans, when we come back in one-on-one competition, it's Big Josh against Beautiful Bobby. That match is next.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, making his way into the ring area from the Northwoods at 270 pounds, here comes Big Josh.
Fans, don't forget the action this Wednesday in Little Rock, Arkansas, this Thursday in Alexandria, Louisiana, Friday night in Shreveport, Louisiana, 1 week from tonight in Monroe at the Civic Center, and then 1 week from tomorrow, that's 1 week from tomorrow at 3 o'clock in the afternoon in the downtown Municipal Auditorium in the Crescent City of New Orleans, Louisiana. And now let's go back to America's leading country music personality, Rhubarb Jones. In color, dangerously easy to spot. He's the one in the purple suit. congratulations to Beautiful Bobby. It was on this broadcast last week that Beautiful Bobby and Arn Anderson broke the arm of Larry Zbyszko. And as I mentioned, we'll be talking to Larry Zbyszko a little bit later in this hour. And in just a few moments, ladies and gentlemen, I will be joined here at ringside by Paul E. Dangerously.
And did I make it over here quick enough for you, Jimbo?
Well, yeah, as a matter of fact, you're a little too quick. You could have waited a little while, it would have been fine. But in any event, you're here, and we've got an outstanding contest, one-on-one contest between Big Josh, the powerhouse from the Northwoods, and Beautiful Bobby Eaton.
Well, Big Josh is a big, bad powerhouse, but he's about one burrito shy of a combination plate. Beautiful Bobby, on the other hand, is one half of the greatest, most vicious, most awesome tag team in the history of WCW, as Larry Zbyszko can attest to after last week.
Big Josh working on the arm. Beautiful Bobby, well, it's well known now in the wrestling world that you have made a deal with Williams and Gordy for Eaton and Anderson to eliminate the Steiner brothers. And I don't know what they're paying you. I know it's a lot of yen, but it is certainly going to be a tall, tall order, I can assure you.
Well, it's in Japanese currency because, as you know, the economy here in America is going right down the toilet. Dr. Death and Bam Bam are two of the greatest competitors in the history of WCW. Even you would agree with that, correct?
I agree, yes. Good takedown there by Big Josh. Good armbar takedown.
Doc and Gordy want competition, and the Steiners cannot provide them that competition. The Steiners are a mere annoyance to Doc and Gordy. The Steiners, who stole the World Tag Team titles from Bobby and Arn.
I don't recall that, but
well, you weren't there. All right, May 3rd, 1992 in Chicago, Illinois, the Steiners stole the World Tag Team titles from Bobby Eaton and Arn Anderson and never gave them a rematch, because before the rematch took place, they lost our belts to Doc and Gordy. Doc and Gordy want real competition, and the only competition that's here in WCW worthy of Doc and Gordy are Bobby and Arn, who can't get a title shot because the Steiners are the number one contenders.
Well, those are debatable points, to say the least, as Beautiful Bobby forces Big Josh back in the corner, or the ropes, rather, and nails him with the right hand on the break. Comes back with another right, and the right hand got in. Beautiful Bobby with that lethal right hand, and it found its mark there.
You know, if Evander Holyfield ever had enough guts to go against Bobby Eaton, Bobby would knock him out in the third round.
Big Josh, good move. Good athletic move by Big Josh. And now he shows his power. Scoop slam with a great deal of authority here.
But you see, now look how merciful Big Josh has been. And that's a mistake that Bobby Eaton and Arn Anderson have never, ever made. They've never been merciful, and now more vicious, more animalistic, hungrier than ever, because once we get by the Steiner brothers, once they eliminate the Steiner brothers and take Doc and Gordy's yen, then we actually get a shot at the World Tag Team title, which Doc and Gordy want because they want nothing but competition. The gentlemen and sportsmen that they are.
Right. As Big Josh continues to work on the arm, and now the front face lock applied to Beautiful Bobby.
I mean, can you think of any other reason why Doc and Gordy would want to hire Bobby and Arn to eliminate the Steiners?
Probably because they don't want to try to do it themselves. They've been in some real wars with Rick and Scott Steiner. Do you guys have to give a refund if you don't get the job done?
We've already got our money up front.
Snapmare takeover into the reverse chin lock.
I'm from New York City. When you hire a hit, you get your money first.
Beautiful Bobby now, the reverse chin lock in control. He's grounded his larger opponent.
And notice the leverage that Beautiful Bobby is using. He's wearing Big Josh down just by laying on top of him.
Referee Nick Patrick checking to see that the hold is a legal one and not restricting the oxygen flow.
See, this is yet another illustration of Beautiful Bobby's talents. Everybody said for a while, oh, he's just a tag team wrestler, but he's manhandling Big Josh. They said he can only fly through the air, but look at the ground attack. Ooh. Of Beautiful Bobby.
Beautiful Bobby with a shoulder block downstairs. Rather an orthodox move as he really came out of the blocks there. Double leg pickup, but Big Josh shoots him off and uses his leg strength to take Beautiful Bobby down and caught him with a drop kick. Big Josh uncharacteristically goes to the air here, and now back to work on the arm. Or perhaps Beautiful Bobby could end up like Larry Zbyszko did last week.
Oh, I don't think that, but I will give Big Jerk a little credit. He knew he had to change his game plan against Beautiful Bobby because the one that he was using just was not working. As for Larry Zbysko, who has spent the past decade bitching and moaning, I retired Bruno, I retired Bruno. Let me be the first one to say the Dangerous Alliance retired Larry the Cruncher Zbysko.
And speaking of Larry Zbysko, we will speak with him in this program. He will be joining the broadcast team here at WCW on TBS. He'll be on the Power Hour beginning next Saturday morning with Tony Schiavone, Teddy Long, Missy Hyatt, and the Cruncher.
It's like just all those old football players who have nothing better to do than go on to Monday Night Football. Zbysko's career in the ring is over, and all it took was one maneuver off the top rope by Beautiful Bobby Eaton.
Beautiful Bobby used the hair that time.
I didn't see that.
To free himself. Well, I did. Take my word for it. It did happen, as he now has the head scissors on Big Josh.
And he locks the arm. The same arm that he broke Larry Zbysko's with one maneuver off the top rope, which has been banned by your buddy, Cal Pie Bill Watts.
Well, the fans, I think, will be able to help perhaps do something about that, because we're going to have a vote. It is an election year, you know. We'll have a vote on Wednesday night, September the 2nd, during the Clash of the Champions, and a couple of those big main events have been signed, and we'll be telling you about those a little bit later in this hour.
Who are you voting for in this election year?
I keep my political preferences confidential.
I'm voting for my favorite Democrat, Jesse.
Hammerlock. Jesse Jackson?
No, Jesse the Body Ventura. He's mayor of Brooklyn.
That's up in Minnesota, Brooklyn Park.
Brooklyn Park, Brooklyn, New York. It's all the same thing to me.
You guys are cut out of the same cloth, so I could understand you.
Yeah, we're both successful. We're both number one in our field, and both of us admire a true talent.
Ooh.
Wham!
Wow,
like
right
Beautiful
hand.
Bobby.
Beautiful Bobby with the right hand, and down goes Big Josh. Beautiful Bobby has gotten that right hand in a couple of times, and Big Josh retaliates. Beautiful Bobby exchanging the rights as Big Josh comes with the lefts. There's a knife edge, and now Beautiful Bobby in trouble. Side headlock applied. Great move. Big Josh on great agility. A forearm. The flying forearm knocks Beautiful Bobby all the way out to the apron.
But what good does that do Big Josh, because he can't pin Bobby on the outside?
Well, he can get him ready for a pin, that's for sure. Brings him back in where he can finish him off. Big Josh.
And he can't go to the top rope either.
He's not going to come off the top. His feet are squarely on the second turnbuckle.
Man!
Oh, the Northern Exposure. And Beautiful Bobby got the knees up.
Well, you can cancel Big Josh's date tonight, wouldn't you say?
Let's see if Eaton can capitalize on this break.
Bobby needs to go for the pin, because just like in basketball, you cannot score if you don't shoot.
Eaton out. Putting Big Josh across the second rope, ripping at his face and eyes. I can say this, in the last couple of weeks, I have never in my life seen Eaton and Anderson more focused and more deadly than they have been in the last, like I said, a couple of weeks. Eaton ramming Josh's head into the top turnbuckle, and Big Josh is in trouble as Eaton doesn't allow a lot of distance to come between him and his opponent here.
He's like a shark that smells blood. Beautiful Bobby is not going to give Big Josh one bit of room to breathe. And as for what you were saying about Eaton and Anderson, the Dangerous Alliance is exactly that. We are a dangerous alliance, and despite any rumors to the contrary, we are more dangerous, more volatile, and more vicious than ever. Just ask Zbysko.
Knife edge again by Big Josh. And another hard hit right to the chest. Irish whip is reversed right at you here. Coming to the corner. Big Josh, he's got him rolled up. He could have him right here at Eaton. Reverses it. Beautiful Bobby's feet are in the ropes, but he got the pin.
The winner of the match, Beautiful Bobby.
A Beautiful Bobby reversed the pinning predicament that he was in. Executed an inside cradle. But I don't think the referee saw it, but I thought his feet were in the ropes. We'll take another. Welcome back, everyone, to TBS and WCW Saturday Night. As many of you know, the big battle for the United States Heavyweight Championship between Nikita Koloff and Ravishing Rick Rude is hotter than ever. And I remember on Sunday night, August the 2nd, before the all heck broke loose, proverbially, you had things going your way, Nikita, against the Ravishing One.
Yeah, and in case anyone missed it the first time, I'd like them to pay close attention to this.
Let's go back to Baltimore, Maryland, ladies and gentlemen, and show you just exactly what we're talking about. Nikita Koloff was in control. Take a look at the videotape.
I'll tell you what, you want Nikita Koloff's temper to come through all of a sudden. It'll happen in this situation. Nobody likes to be pushed around like a dog, including myself and including Nikita.
Right hand by the champion. Rude, as Sting mentioned earlier in this matchup, has a great deal of confidence. And that's certainly coming to light right here as he nails the challenger with another right hand.
Oh, I see that look. I know that look. Oh!
Koloff trying to block the pain. He blocked the right hand. Comes back with right hands of his own. Irish whip.
Fire it up, Nick.
Got him.
This is the chance right here.
Koloff now reasserting himself. Shoulder block. The champion's
beautiful.
In trouble.
Stick with it.
He may have it. He may have it. He's got two.
That was too close.
United States Heavyweight Championship hangs in the balance here. Koloff with a slam. Another near fall. Koloff on two occasions now. Only one count away from becoming the new United States Heavyweight Champion. Koloff slamming him down. Again. Oh, he got two.
You got to hit it to Rude. You got to hit it to Rude right now. He's hanging tough too.
Rude in serious trouble, and his championship hangs in the balance. Koloff is
there. There's that power.
Oh, Rude there, the referee.
That's it.
He's got him. He got
this
him with
could
a
be
second.
It right here. He's
got
referee,
him.
I know this feeling too, Rossi.
I think the tape speaks for itself, and of course, tomorrow in the Omni, 3 o'clock starting time, the match has been re-signed, Koloff and Rude for the U.S. title, but this time Medusa will be barred from the entire facility.
JR, that's all I've asked for all along. It's to have Ravishing Rick Rude, one-to-one, man-to-man competition. No DA, no Medusa, just you and I, Ravishing Rick Rude. And tomorrow in the Omni, you have to walk the aisle, and I have to walk the aisle. And we'll see right there in the Omni, Ravishing Rick Rude, Shito Ita, who can walk out as champion. Just remember one thing, Ravishing Rick Rude. It's only going to take one sickle for the 1, 2, 3. And now, Shito Ita, Ravishing Rick Rude, I can't think of a better place than right here in Atlanta, right in the Omni, to walk out as champion and once again become the people's champion. I'll see you in the Omni tomorrow. Shito Ita.
And that big event starts at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and we'll be back right after this timeout.
Good God!
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, with a combined weight of 551 pounds, they are the Vegas Connection, the team of Vinny Vegas and Diamond Dallas Page! Introducing their opponents already in the ring with a combined weight of 490 pounds, the Italian Stallion and Chad Bird.
Tag team action here, ladies and gentlemen, on TBS. Welcome back, and thanks for being with us. The Vegas Connection of Big Benny Vegas and Diamond Dallas Page have a matchup signed soon with the Junkyard Dog and the Big Cat. Let's hear from the biggest dog and the biggest cat in WCW. Here's what they had to say earlier today.
That's right, Danny. It's Big Cat and Junkyard Dog. We got a score to settle with some people. Tell them about it.
Hey, you're looking all red now. We're watching you, Venice Vegas and Dallas Page. So, one, come on. Let's have ourselves a ball on this night.
Oh,
Should be an interesting tag team matchup. Vegas and Page against JYD and Big Cat. I know our fans down in Louisiana, our fans in Little Rock, Arkansas, looking forward to seeing the return of the Junkyard Dog. And that will be this week, as we mentioned. The Italian Stallion, outstanding competitor in AAU wrestling, with a wrist lock applied to Diamond Dallas Page. Well, fans, two matches have been signed, as you saw, for the Clash of the Champions. It'll be live here on TBS. Our theme will be the 20th anniversary of wrestling on TBS. We're going to invite Gordon Solie back and many other dignitaries that made wrestling so great here on the Superstation, beginning in the 70s, throughout the 80s. Nice elbow there by Diamond Dallas Page. Ron Simmons and Cactus Jack for the world title, live in prime time right here. And what do you think about the eight-man tag team elimination match? The match continues until one team has been completely eliminated. Rude, Jake the Snake, Big Van Vader, and Super Invader against the Steiner Brothers, Nikita Koloff, and Sting as Big Vinny Vegas comes in. That event again on Wednesday, September 2nd, 8:05 Eastern, 2.5 hours live right here from Center Stage. Vegas working on the arm, extending it, and using the knee lift to try to knot up the tricep. Another wrist lock applied. Tag has been made. Chad Bird, newcomer here to WCW. In there! Well, he won't soon forget his debut. Tremendous clothesline by the 6 foot, 10 inch, 300 pounder. A very brash young team that certainly doesn't lack in self-confidence, a gut wrench. Vegas at 6'10", certainly can create a substantial leverage advantage over most opponents, and Page is about 6'5". Combination offense by Page and Vegas, making the exchange on the tag. Page in now, dropping the knee to Chad Bird. Page with the right hand. Fans, we're going to be talking to Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. I'm anxious to hear his status. Certainly like to find out how Larry's broken arm is healing. Nice teamwork again. Good teamwork by Page in Vegas, as Page really taking advantage after making the tag. The referee's count stayed in the ring and added some more punishment. Just as Vegas has done here with a suplex. Diamond Dallas Page dropping the leg on Chad Bird, hooks the leg, and this one is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the event, the team of Vinny Vegas and Diamond Dallas Page, the Vegas Connection.
So Page and Vegas to take on the Junkyard Dog and the Big Cat. That tag team match coming up very soon. Some good tag team effort here by Page and Vegas, as they won it quite convincingly. And fans, when we come back, we'll talk to Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko, and we'll relive a moment that perhaps has shortened his career when we come back on WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross back here on TBS and WCW Saturday Night with Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. It was here last week, Larry, that you sustained the broken arm, and I'm sure the fans are all concerned about your status.
Well, we'll get to the broken arm later. I want everybody to see exactly the lows they stooped to do this.
Let's go back 1 week, ladies and gentlemen. It was beautiful Bobby Eaton and Arn Anderson, the culprits in this situation. Here's what happened 7 days ago.
Pillman really getting emotionally involved in this, and rightfully so, quite frankly. But he's got to be there in his corner in case Zbyszko can be there to make the tag. Slam, vintage Minnesota wrecking crew, if you will. Hammerlock into the body slam. Anderson continuing to pull on that left arm. Fans, as we mentioned, good move by Larry up into the headlock, but Anderson makes a tag. Fans, we've got to take a commercial break. We will keep taping this contest. If anything happens during the commercial break, we'll show it to you as soon as we come back. I think we're ready for our break. Fans, we'll be back with more of this contest right after this timeout. Don't you go away. Oh. Well, fans, it's really gotten chaotic here at center stage during the commercial break. Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby really did a number on Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. It looks as if Zbyszko has suffered a broken arm. As we said before we went to the commercial break, fans, that we would keep the cameras running. Our tape machines have documented what has happened during our timeout. Let's go now back and show you what has happened just a few moments ago right here at center stage. Anderson and Eaton continue to work on the arm. Zbyszko's arm very, very weakened. More arm bar takedowns. And then the tag was made. Remember, the off the top rope rule had been waived. And this was the move that apparently has broken the arm of Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. Zbyszko couldn't take any more punishment. The referee has stopped it here.
I know, Larry, that's a tough thing to see again.
You know something, Ross? Broken arms and pain are an unfortunate part of the wrestling game. Now, I'm a real sick individual. I've been playing this game of beating people up and getting beat up for 17 glorious years because I love this game. And you know something? I've discovered a game that I love just as much that I'm going to incorporate into the wrestling game. And you know what it is? It's called the revenge game. Money just buys junk. Revenge is soothing to the soul. You know, Paulie Dangerously is out here a few months ago telling everybody I was the sickest, most deranged member of the Dangerous Alliance, and he got me. He was right on the money. I am the sickest, most deranged member of what was the Dangerous Alliance. And you remember that, Dangerously, and you and Eaton, you remember it good, because now we're going to play a new game. We're going to play it my way. No more Mr. Nice Guy.
Very strong comments from Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. He'll join Tony Schiavone, Missy Hyatt, and Teddy Long next Saturday on the Power Hour, and we'll be back. Cactus Jack will be here along with Jake the Snake Roberts next on TBS. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it was announced early in the program that live on primetime on Wednesday night, September the 2nd, the heavyweight championship of the world will be contested right here at center stage, live on TBS at the Clash of the Champions. Ron Simmons will defend the world's heavyweight championship against this man, Cactus Jack.
Lo and behold, Jim Ross. A few short weeks ago, Cactus Jack was out here talking title shots, and you looked at me like I was crazy. Well, the WCW board of directors picked up on a good thing, and Ron Simmons, I gotta congratulate you on having the guts to do what no man has ever had the guts to do before. Put your title on the line against me. And not only that, Jim, September 2nd, Clash of the Champions, it's live. Which means you can't edit me out. You can't censor the violence. And no matter how ugly it may get, you can't turn off the cameras and pretend it didn't happen. Yeah, Ron Simmons, something real ugly is gonna happen to you. And its name is Cactus Jack. Because not only does Cactus Jack, world champion, have a nice ring to it, on September 2nd, it's gonna have a nice belt too.
Thank you very much, Cactus Jack. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go back up to Rhubarb Jones.
Bye bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first from Stone Mountain, Georgia, at 258 pounds, Jake the Snake Roberts.
And here he comes, ladies and gentlemen. One of the most sadistic athletes in the history of the game, Jake the Snake Roberts.
You got that right, Jim Ross. You got that right.
And this is not the beginning.
Introducing his opponent from Lenoir, North Carolina, 280 pounds, Randy Stalling.
Yet it is the end of the beginning.
Well, Jake the Snake Roberts' own rendition of that bizarre music that brought him to the ring really is indicative of his attitude on life. And this is the man that on August the 2nd, in front of a near-capacity crowd in Baltimore, Maryland, attacked Sting, and was blatantly obvious to me that he tried to end his career. Two DDTs on a steel chair, Cactus Jack, and there's that huge snake. We saw that. Apparently the snake is in that bag. I would, if it is, leave it there.
Jake Roberts got a lot of surprises in that bag. He's a sick and evil man. It's no wonder he's somebody I've looked up to for a long time.
You admire this guy?
Oh, how can you not? Did you see that sight? Did you see Jake Roberts coming over the barricade? It reminded me of John Wayne, with one exception. John Wayne smoked butts. Jake Roberts kicks them. And you can ask Sting for the evidence there. He puts Sting out of commission like no man has ever. And I'm one of those men, too.
Roberts, a real superstar in the sport, and has always been a little off-center. He has always danced to the beat of an entirely different drummer. You have to wonder what motivates this man. What has provoked his mindset to be one of the most evil and sadistic human beings to ever compete in the squared circle anywhere around the world?
Hey, it's no secret. If you want to achieve success in WCW, you've got to force their hand. That's exactly what Jake Roberts did with Sting. He had either one of two choices. He could have gone to jail, or WCW could have hired him. It was all up to Sting, and Sting, showing more guts than brains, decided he wanted Jake Roberts, and that might be his last mistake. The short arm clothesline, Jim Ross, you know what that sets up, don't you?
Indeed we do. The man that invented the DDT, and the crowd wants it, but he doesn't want to give it to them.
Jake Roberts did not get to the top of the heap by giving the fans what they want. He calls the shots, and now the shot's all there.
There it was, the DDT, except there was no steel folding chair.
Well, trust me, he's the originator, he's the implementator, and that is a finishing move.
Jake the Snake Roberts!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'll thank Cactus Jack for being with us, and we will be talking to Jake the Snake Roberts in a few moments. It could be in the Omni tomorrow at 3:00 in the afternoon, or it could be in prime time.
There it is, Jim. Nobody does it better. You don't need a steel folding chair, because I assure you one thing, that man's not getting up.
The big eight-man elimination tag team match, Sting and Jake both on opposing teams, and we'll talk to Jake Roberts momentarily.
This is not the end. And this is not the beginning.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as I mentioned, it could happen tomorrow afternoon in the Omni. Remember, it's Kids Day Out at the Omni. Two kids admitted free with each paid adult admission. 3:00 is the starting time here in Atlanta. It has been signed, as you all know, Jake the Snake Roberts and Sting. But none of us will ever forget what transpired on Sunday, August the 2nd in Baltimore, Maryland.
Don't you understand? If you go out fishing, do you put a little bait on the hook? If you go out hunting, do you use a dog? Only if you're smart. That's exactly what I done. I set the trap. It was very simple. Because you see, Sting, you're a simple man. I set the trap and you fell for it like a fish. Swallowed the hook. You came down, I came down. Sure, if I want to grab the bull by the tail, I don't get much done, do I? No, you have to go to the head, to the front. And that's exactly what I did with you, Sting. I punished you. But simply because you deserve to be punished. People that stand above and look down and think they know the answer. You don't have a clue. Yeah, DDT once, DDT twice. All in a good night's work, Sting. I'm gonna teach you a very valuable lesson. You don't play with snakes without expecting to get bit. You show up in the Omni. All I'm asking you to do, Sting, right now, do yourself a favor, do these kids out here a favor, and quit. Simply put the tights up, put the boots in the closet, and quit. Don't you think it's smarter to keep quiet and be thought a fool than to speak up and erase all doubt? Would you? Do you think Sting would use drugs?
No.
No, Sting wouldn't use drugs. Would Sting drink and drive?
Of course not.
Would Sting take a gun and put 5 shells in a 6-shell chamber and play Russian roulette?
Obviously not, Jake.
Then don't show up at the Omni. They say it's kids' day out. That's sick. You think I'm sick? That is sick. You're wanting the kids to come down and watch the end of a man's career. If that's what WCW wants, and that's what Sting wants, then it will be done. 3 o'clock. Time's up.
Fans, we'll be back with more on WCW Saturday night. Right. I don't need to see the snack right after this. Keep it in the bag.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, at 236 pounds, from the state of Wyoming, Young Pistol, Tracy Smothers. And introducing his opponent, from Cincinnati, Ohio, at 224 pounds, here comes Flying Brian.
Flying Brian, the former WCW World's Light Heavyweight Champion. And another outstanding light heavyweight, Tracy Smothers, in this one-on-one confrontation. Nick Patrick, the referee. Thanks for being with us here, everyone. Want to remind you very quickly, the WCW magazine is on sale right now. Just went on the newsstands this past Tuesday. Barry Windham is featured in the giant two-sided centerfold, big poster. One side is a studio pose. The flip side is an action shot of Barry against Arn Anderson. Dr. Dusty Williams and Scott Steiner are on the cover, and that's on sale wherever newsstands or wherever magazines are sold. It is without a doubt the leading wrestling publication in the world today, as Pillman with a wrist lock, giving away about 11 pounds here to Young Pistol Tracy Smothers. A couple of weeks ago, I talked with Gary Burley and Wilson Whitley and Ross Brown, a former defensive lineman of the Cincinnati Bengals, and they finally recall the toughest little guy on the football team, and that was Flying Brian Pillman. Wasn't known as Flying Brian then. They called him the Kamikaze because he took every chance in the book. Good hip lock takeover. Great drive kick. Youngster's got great athletic skills, but so does Smothers for that matter. I mentioned earlier in the program when we were talking about Johnny B. Badd, that Brad Armstrong out of action right now with a knee injury. We don't know how long Brad's gonna be out of competition, but when he is healthy and he's back in action, you can bet that athletes like Johnny B. Badd, and especially Flying Brian Pillman, would love to have the opportunity to wrestle the youngster from Marietta, Georgia for the light heavyweight title. Mother's trying to turn Flying Brian on his shoulders. Did so momentarily. Pillman's days with the Bengals, he was a special teams player, played linebacker, but was mostly a special teams player, a real kamikaze-like athlete on kickoffs, kickoff returns, and so forth. So he had, you gotta have a, they say you're maybe a sandwich or two short of a picnic to play on the special teams, but Pillman was a special team star for 3 seasons for the Bengals. As Smothers gets the arm in a rope, and we have a clean break. A lot of athletes inquiring about wrestling now in WCW. They see that the competition here is tougher than anywhere in the world, and we've got some of those names on the wrestling hotline, and you're gonna be surprised at what you hear on the hotline until midnight tonight. Liam Ryan, good move there by Pillman. Still maintaining his control with the armbar. Fans, I hope you'll join me tomorrow night on AM 750 WSB. Wrestling with Jim Ross starts at 9 o'clock, and I'll have Jake the Snake Roberts live in the studio tomorrow night to take your calls beginning at 9 o'clock as Smothers bridges up away from the pinning predicament. But Pillman holds on to the wrist lock. I know Brian felt very, very badly to be involved in that situation last week with Larry the Crutch Zbyszko, but it certainly was not Brian's fault, to say the least.
All the blame's got to go on squarely on the shoulders. Arn Anderson and beautiful Bobby Eaton. As Smothers misses the elbow, Pillman showed great quickness there to avoid it. Drop toe hold, floats over. Again, controlling the arm. Pillman, half Nelson, throws Smothers over, and that would have been an amateur match. This one would be over. Takes three in the pros. I know the top stars in WCW will be headed toward the old Mid-South wrestling area beginning this Wednesday, as we mentioned, in Little Rock. Then Thursday, Friday, Saturday in Alexandria, Shreveport, and Monroe, and then ending up on Sunday afternoon, a week from tomorrow, in New Orleans. Has Smothers with a shoulder, buries it there. Has Pillman now in trouble in the corner. Sends him to the other side. Pillman with great agility. And Smothers ran right into that one. And Flying Brian head scissors him right outside on the floor. I am Ryan now. Got that foot out there and rammed it in the chest of Smothers, and Smothers fell back against the security railing. May have hurt his elbow there. Still to come in the hour, Dirty Dick Slater takes on the Z-Man. The world's heavyweight champion Ron Simmons will be here. We'll also see Big Van Vader in action, and the Stinger will be with us. So a lot more action to come, and thanks for staying with us here as Pillman with another drop toe hold. Many people thought that when the top rope rule was put into effect in WCW by Cowboy Bill Watts that it would restrict Pillman's abilities, but I don't think it's affected his one loss record whatsoever. And again, the fans that watch our broadcast on Wednesday night, September the 2nd, will have the opportunity to voice their opinion on the top rope rule as Pillman catches Smothers coming in. And Smothers now made a great counter move, a big counter move right there. Smothers catches Pillman in the power slam. And Smothers now doing a little perhaps too much talking, not really following up as quickly as perhaps he would like if he goes back and looks at this videotape. Smothers with a great power slam and comes back with another power move as he caught Flying Brian there in that backbreaker. Smothers is the stronger of the two athletes in this contest. Smothers now going up on the second rope for additional leverage. Double axe handle caught Pillman right in the spine. And Flying Brian now has found himself in a high degree of jeopardy as Smothers, who is improving each and every week, comes back with a martial arts move. Pillman out on the apron. Referee Nick Patrick trying to force Smothers back. Good officiating there. Smothers still comes in with a cheap shot. And Pillman caught him coming in. The crossbody, and he couldn't hold him for two. Pillman's still a little wobbly, and even more so now as Smothers got up very quickly and nailed him with a clothesline. And now let's see if Smothers can wrap it up here. And Pillman kicked out at 2.5. Smothers a half a count away from defeating Flying Brian Pillman here on WCW Saturday night. Snap merging back down. Well, he's grounded Eric Pillman quite successfully here. Much like the Cleveland Browns grounded the Red Gun Attack last week. I don't think that's going to happen tonight in Tampa Bay. Hope you fans are listening on AM 750 WSB for the Falcons and the Bucks. Kickoffs at 7 o'clock tonight. First chin lock. He's got it tied in there tightly. His knee is right in the mid-back area for additional leverage. Textbook application, but Pillman, you see, trying to turn chest to chest with Smothers. He has done so now, back up to a vertical base. The elbow to the midsection. Good shoulder lock. And Smothers again caught him with a high impact move. That's about the third one in this contest. He ought to have him right here. One, two, and Pillman got another shoulder up. He got the left shoulder up this time. The tough kid from Cincinnati who just will not quit. His old coach, Sam Weich, is the coach of the
Tampa Bay Buccaneers. This Smothers with that martial arts kick caught Pillman in the head, and Flying Brian did that. He flew outside, whereas you see there is no padding. Smothers there on the apron, again with a double axe handle, and again it found its mark. Smothers looks very, very effective here as he has successfully grounded Flying Brian. He's worked on the back, and he has worked on it relentlessly in this matchup. Smothers was an outstanding college football player, as we've documented, one of the great NAIA programs in America, Carson Newman, up in Tennessee. Coming inside cradle. Good counter move, but didn't have enough strength that time to hold Smothers. Irish whip. Flying Brian caught him with that cross body, and again he got a near fall. And again, Smothers comes back with that double axe handle, again catching Flying Brian in the mid-back area. And both men going for drop kicks, neither really hitting their mark. I think both men now falling back on their heads. No, neither man with the advantage, but if anyone could have an advantage, it perhaps would be Smothers, as Pillman has really been punished the last 2 or 3 minutes of this match. Smothers, Irish whip, far side. Went for the martial arts, but missed it. And Pillman caught him. Eric Pillman caught him with that big time clothesline. Tremendous chops there. Irish whip reversed. Smothers got him again, but this time Pillman countered it with a head scissors. Oh, what a move. Smothers again going for the backbreaker. Tremendous chop there. Great counter move by Flying Brian. And the fiery youngster from Cincinnati hammering away at Smothers. And now Pillman up on the second turnbuckle. Caught him with a drop kick. Hooks the leg, and let's see if he can hold him. And Smothers shows his tenacity as he got his right shoulder up. Ooh, what a chop. Pillman very, very aggressive. And that's his style. Head and shoulder fake, got Smothers off his feet. And Smothers caught Pillman this time. Pillman took a big chance coming off the second rope, and Smothers caught him with a karate kick. And Smothers now, let's see if he can put him away. Hooks a near leg, and Pillman got the left shoulder up. Maybe a tactical error there. Perhaps if Smothers would have hooked the far leg, he could have held him down, but it was not to be. Pillman's got him there in a crucifix. Let's see if he can hold him this time. One, two, three, he does.
The winner of the match, Flying Brian.
Well, fans, as we said, the Clash of Champions live in prime time here on TBS Wednesday night, September the 2nd from Center Stage. We'll take another look at what has been signed on that card in just a moment as we look at the closing moments of this contest. Pillman used a great move, the crucifix. Hooks the legs around the arms. Pillman with a victory. Thanks very much for staying with us, everyone. Still to come, Big Van Vader plus the new WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World, Ron Simmons. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring out a man that will meet Jake the Snake Roberts tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock in the Omni. He's from Venice Beach, California. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Center Stage, Sting. This athlete, without a doubt, the most popular athlete to ever compete in WCW. He lost his opportunity for the rematch thanks to Jake the Snake Roberts, but that debt can be repaid in kind right here in Atlanta tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock. Stinger, I know you're ready. It's Kids Day Out tomorrow at 3, and you've got Jake the Snake Roberts in the Omni.
Yeah, Rossi, who is that guy that walks to the ring carrying a snake with him everywhere he goes? Is it Jake the Snake?
That's what I think they call him.
Yes, it is. How about the guy that gave me a couple of DDTs, whacked me with a chair in the back? Who is that?
That's Jake the Snake Roberts.
Yeah, speaking of that snake bit a couple of guys, made him real sick one time, didn't it? Didn't it?
Right.
Yes, it did make a couple of guys real sick, but let me tell you something, Jake. Do you think I'm like a little puppy dog that's gonna roll over and play dead for you? Or like I'm a little puppet? You pull a string and you can scare the stinger? You think I could look ringside into the eyes of one of those little stingers and tell him no, I couldn't do it because I was afraid, or worse yet, look at myself in the mirror in the morning and say I couldn't do it because Jake scared me? Not a chance, because when I was a kid, they told me I couldn't wrestle Jake because I wasn't big enough. But I am now. And then I blew out my knee and they said I'd never come back. But I'm wrestling now, Jake. And come Sunday night in the Omni, Jake, I know you. But the problem is, my friend, you don't know who the hell I am.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, some very strong words from the Stinger. That event starts at 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon right here in Atlanta in the Omni. Let's go back up to Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, making his way into the ring area at 239 pounds from Tampa, Florida, Dirty Dick Slater.
Rhubarb Jones introducing Dirty Dick Slater. But some very strong words. You can see the emotion and the intensity in the Stinger. What a matchup that will be. You know he'd love to wrestle Ron Simmons for the World's Heavyweight Championship. Jake Roberts saw that Sting would lose his opportunity against Big Van Vader. But Sting has business to take care of now, and that is with one Jake the Snake Roberts.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way into the ring area, he hails from Minneapolis, Minnesota, at 235 pounds, here comes Z-Man!
The ever-popular Z-Man to take on the double-tough veteran, Dirty Dick Slater. We heard comments from Slater and Valentine earlier in the program. As Valentine and Slater prepare to meet Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham in a big tag team matchup. Referee Randy Anderson assigned this contest, and the bell sounds and we're ready to go here. Fans, as I said, still to come. World's Heavyweight Champion Ron Simmons will be in action here. And we'll also see Big Van Vader take on two men. He didn't want to wrestle one man, he wanted to wrestle two men. Slater forcing the Z-Man back into the corner. Collar and elbow tie up Z-Man now. Turning the table somewhat on the veteran from Tampa, Florida. Nice hip lock takeover. I'm sure Slater is a Buccaneer fan, so we have little in common. Side headlock applied by the Z-Man. Certainly one of the most talented young athletes in WCW. Great light heavyweight himself, 235. Slater, 239. So the weight difference will be really obscure in this one. Z-Man with a headlock. I'm sure he wants to keep it relatively basic here, but I know that he would like to wrestle a faster match than Slater is accustomed to. Slater a little more methodical, as is his partner Greg the Hammer Valentine. They like to dictate the pace, and they certainly when they can do that, they just don't make many errors. Z-Man, on the other hand, loves to use his quickness and speed, something Slater's got to be aware of in this matchup. Front face lock, Slater going for a suplex. Z-Man blocked it and came with a suplex of his own and right back into the reverse chin lock. So Z-Man is controlling the action here in the early going of this contest. Fans, as many of you have requested, we will show you tomorrow on the main event with Tony Schiavone and Magnum TA, Ron Simmons' victory over Big Van Vader in its entirety from Baltimore. So get your VCRs ready for that one as Slater tries to gain a cheap victory here. Using the tights, the referee saw that. I think the referees are doing a tremendous job here in WCW.
Senior referee Ole Anderson has really got him doing an outstanding job in a very thankless position, I can tell you that from experience, and a great concentration by the Z-Man, holding on to that side headlock even though he was suplexed, refusing to let go. And Slater finally over on top, lateral press there, and Z-Man almost found himself on the losing end of this one. Good chain wrestling move by Slater, but a drop toe by Z-Man. Again, Slater finds himself at on the defensive here. Z-Man working on the legs, but what we're seeing here is he's keeping Slater grounded. Slater known as an outstanding mat wrestler. Z-Man known as an outstanding aerial wrestler, but perhaps the Z-Man is crossing up Slater here somewhat by not attempting any high-risk moves thus far. Oh, Slater sidestepped the Z-Man and took him all the way outside. Again, there's nothing there to cushion the fall. He fell right on the floor. And Z-Man will have a count of 10 to get back in the ring, but Slater wanting to add further damage here, waiting out on the apron. Z-Man, he was just a target there. Slater kicked him in the back of the head. Z-Man didn't even see that one coming. And again, the Z-Man is trying to shake it loose here on the outside. Referee Randy Anderson, as we mentioned, has a 10 count to utilize. Slater measures the youngster from Minneapolis. Caught him with a forearm and then a knee to the head. And stomps him with a flat of the foot, and Z-Man having a heck of a hard time returning to the ring. Technically, Slater's got to give Z-Man the opportunity to return, and I know that's easier said than done. That's the theory behind the rule. And the referee up to 8 here now. And Z-Man back in there at 8. Slater there to meet him. Caught him with the right hand. Slater using his fists very effectively. A right hand knocks a Z-Man down. So the Z-Man in a great deal of trouble here. And Slater going for the side. Russian leg sweep. He got it. And there's a lateral press, and Z-Man able to use his legs to kick out. Slater complaining the count was a little bit slow, but you saw what happens when a wrestler neglects to hook the leg. It allows the other athlete, Z-Man in this case, to use his legs and use them very effectively to kick out. Z-Man with those right hands. Now he's trying to build some momentum, but Slater comes back. This one is turning into more of a brawl than a wrestling contest. Irish whips him in, and Z-Man brings Slater right out of the corner. Flips him right out using his leg strength. Backs him in the corner again, Irish whip this time. No, it's reversed, and Z-Man catches Slater coming in with that kick. And he went for the drop kick, and Slater was able to sidestep it, and Z-Man fell right on his head. Slater now with that pile driver. He is very proficient with a pile driver. This time he hooks the leg, and this time he gets 3.
The winner of the match, Dirty Dick Slater.
Slater with a one-on-one victory here using his pile driver. And as we said earlier, Slater and Valentine gearing up and preparing to meet Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham in tag team action. And there you see Slater with his pile driver, dropping Z-Man right on his head. Fans, when we come back, we'll talk to Teddy Long, and we'll see Ron Simmons in one-on-one competition. The world's champion is next.
Wrestling fans, in just a few moments, we'll return to the ring to see the new WCW World's Heavyweight Champion, Ron Simmons, in action. But I want to remind all of you that next Saturday morning, along with Tony Schiavone, Missy Hyatt, Larry Zbyszko, Teddy Long is going to join WCW's broadcast crew on the Power Hour. And Teddy, congratulations and welcome aboard.
Well, thank you so much, Jim Ross. The first thing I want to say is thanks to Bill Watts for making everything all possible. Going to be working with a lot of great people, like you said, Larry Zbyszko, Tony Schiavone, Missy Hyatt. But the big news that I'm out here to talk about is the biggest news in WCW. In fact, it's the biggest news in the history of professional wrestling. And that's my homie, the three-time All-American Ron Simmons, becoming the new WCW World Heavyweight Champion.
He is a great athlete, no doubt about it. I'm sure the fans here at Center Stage and the fans at home are ready to see Big Ron Simmons in action. Without any further ado, let's go back up to our ring announcer, Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion at 275 pounds from Warner Robins, Georgia, here comes Ron Simmons.
Great ovation for Ron Simmons as he makes his way around the ring. A man that always gives his time to the children of the inner cities, the children anywhere you go. This man has a big, big heart, almost as big as his muscles. And they love him here at Center Stage. Let's go back up to Rhubarb.
Introducing his opponent from the State Patrol, Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker.
Fans, as we mentioned, more on the main event with Tony Schiavone and Magnum T.A., 6:05 Eastern Time will be the start. We'll show you the Ron Simmons Van Vader World Title Match from Baltimore in its entirety. You'll see how that man won the heavyweight championship of the world. You'll see the match from start to finish. I'll also talk to Michael Hayes on the broadcast. I'll tell you what, Teddy, this man is really excited about being in the Omni tomorrow at 3:00 in the afternoon. We know it's Kids Day Out. He's got the big rematch of Van Vader. It's like coming home for Ron Simmons tomorrow.
You're exactly right, Jim Ross, and I'll be on hand in the Omni, and I've talked to all the homies all over the hoods everywhere, and all they're talking about is getting down to the Omni to see the new WCW World Heavyweight Champion, and that is Ron Simmons. And don't forget now, Ron Simmons, he'll be meeting Big Van Vader tomorrow night in the Omni, and that sets the stage for Big Ron Simmons to meet Cactus Jack on September 2nd, live Clash of the Champions.
Well, I'll tell you, there's no guarantee that he will meet Cactus Jack on September the 2nd. Cactus has a championship matchup, and after tomorrow afternoon at 3:00 with that big start, we'll see. Well, that story will unfold a little bit, because there's just no guarantee with Big Van Vader on Ron Simmons' heels, Teddy, quite frankly, that he's going to be able to take on Cactus Jack on September the 2nd.
Well, Jim Ross, let me say something about that. Now, Ron Simmons, he had no idea that he was going to become the new WCW World Heavyweight Champion. He had no idea that he was going to meet Big Van Vader that night in Baltimore. But Ron Simmons knew one thing. He knew that his chance was coming. He knew it was going to happen. So he did the right thing. He prepared himself. He trained each and every day. And the key to success is preparation. So Ron Simmons is prepared now. It's like him playing football. He's going to take this thing like you're play football one game at a time. He's going to take it one match at a time. So I'm sure that Ron Simmons will walk out victorious tomorrow night in the Omni, because I'll be there, brother.
Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker got a stiff right hand in there, right on the jaw of Ron Simmons. I was talking to Bobby Butler, great defensive back of the Atlanta Falcons last week up in Cleveland. He was in Ron Simmons' freshman class. And we've got some great stories from Bobby about Ron Simmons. What an athlete. He was a man at 17. And there he got it. He took him all the way around. What a powerhouse. And this one is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the event, the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion, Ron Simmons.
Well, Teddy, we'll see you tomorrow in the Omni. 3:00 now, the starting time. Don't you be late.
Don't you worry. I'll be there, brother.
Ron Simmons throwing Sergeant Parker in. And there's how he won the title. A complete 360. What a power slam. He's all man, no doubt about it. I know, Ron, you've had a busy 2 weeks. A lot of congratulatory things, the telegrams. Your old teammate Bobby Butler sends his regards and says congratulations, but the partying is over. The wars began.
Yes, it has. It started a new era. And it couldn't have happened if it hadn't been for all those people out there. This belt is for you. And like you said, Jim, the party is over. But the party's still going on, because I'm not going to let these people down. First of all, I don't want to let myself down. I appreciate all of the support, all the letters that came in. And one thing you can count on, and Ron Simmons will defend this title with every ounce of sweat, every drop of strength in my body, because this belt means to me what makes being an All-American. It means to me being an idol for these kids. I'm going to show them that dreams do come true, and it is possible to make your way in this world if you have a goal.
Around tomorrow at 3 o'clock, you've got that rematch with Big Van Vader. A lot of guys want a shot, including Sting, Ricky Steamboat, all these guys that are deserving of the opportunity. But first, it's Big Van Vader tomorrow here in Atlanta at 3.
The contract has been signed, and that is the policy. Whenever there's been a change of hands in the belt, that you must give the former champion a rematch. I'm going to give him that because I'm going to prove to not only Van Vader, but to the world that Ron Simmons is no fluke, no fly-by-night champion. I beat him square in the middle of the ring, and Sting and the Stallions and everyone are good friends of mine, but they know that everyone in this sport wants to be number one, and right now I'm the man. And in order to beat the man, they are going to have to beat me.
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, thanks to Ron Simmons for spending some time with us. What a challenge he has tomorrow, 3 o'clock in Atlanta's Omni. And when we come back, we'll see the man that he must face. 448-pound Big Van Vader is next on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is a handicap match, 2-1. Introducing first, from the Rocky Mountains, at 448 pounds, coming to the ring by Harley Race, here comes Big Van Vader! And introducing his opponents with a combined weight of 430 pounds, Rex Cooper and Danny Deans.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Big Van Vader, the man that has a mandatory rematch coming with Ron Simmons. It doesn't matter where it is. You get the opportunity to see that one. Don't miss it. It will be another war. And remember, tomorrow in the main event, we'll show you that big matchup from Baltimore in its entirety. What a match it was. What emotion. And you'll see it from start to finish in the main event tomorrow. Big Van Vader just planting the man in the corner. Vader with those big clubbing right hands. 448 pounds. With the agility of a man much, much smaller. Fans, next week here on the program, Sting will be with us. He will be wrestling on the program next week. Jake the Snake Roberts will be here as well. And anytime those two are in the same facility, the potential for violence really increases. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat will be here next week. Take on Scotty Flamingo. Hope you'll be with us at 6:05, back at our normal time of 6:05 next Saturday for WCW Saturday Night. Vader, oh gosh, that is power. No athlete can withstand that particular move, along with so many other moves that he executes. This power bomb, even Ron Simmons cannot allow himself to get into that situation. Vader has won this one, beaten two men very, very easily.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Big Van Vader.
All right, fans, don't forget tomorrow, 6:05 Eastern, 5:05 Central on the main event with Tony and Magnum. That man's war with Ron Simmons started in Baltimore on Sunday, August the 2nd. You'll see it in its entirety here tomorrow on TBS, the Powerbomb. Ron Simmons must avoid that tomorrow afternoon in the Omni. If he cannot, then we will see a new world's champion crowned in Atlanta, Georgia tomorrow. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as we said, the rematch has been signed, and obviously Big Van Vader is more than ready.
What's mine, Ron Simmons? No pain, no fear, and no excuses. But Simmons, I've got to tell the world what went down in Baltimore. I trained for Sting. Every ounce of energy in my body was prepared for Sting. And who showed up? Ron Simmons. I trained for Muhammad Ali. And who showed up? Mike Tyson. I trained for Godzilla. And who showed up? King Kong. Yeah, WCW, you tricked the monster. But all you did is get the monster real mad. Now, Ron Simmons, I feel sorry for you because you got the gold, but now there's a price to pay, brother, because Vader is coming after you. Yeah.
All right, Harley, I know you're getting this big matchup 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Obviously, he is really ready.
Tomorrow night in the Omni, Jim Ross, the people of Atlanta are going to get a chance to see what a real man's made out of. And he's standing right here. Ron Simmons, you and I have a lot in common. I won the world's title once and held it for 7 weeks. You're not even going to last that long. The Omni, you're going down, Simmons. You're going down.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thanks very much for being with us. Don't forget the main event tomorrow with Tony Schiavone and Magnum TA. For all of our fans in Atlanta, we'll see you in the Omni starting at 3 o'clock. So long, everybody.